going on YouTube, and today we're gonna do interesting video. By popular demand, I've done video about monitor calibration a little while back, and a lot of you guys asked me to repeat it, to do more in depth, so here it is. It's not gonna be entertaining video, you know. I wish I could put a clown suit with a little nose, so it's gonna be a little bit more fun, but you know, it's gonna be basically like a pure information. So I'm going to show you two different methods we're going to cover in this video. Number one, first thing I'm going to do, we're going to do a calibration basically using operating system. What that means, whether you're using Windows or iOS, we're going to calibrate our display as a color management. So every single time you would start the computer, whatever the mode or preference we're going to calibrate, that's how your monitor going to display. Now, for many of you, it's going to be either sRGB, Rec. 709. If you guys want to be more specific or you have some kind of a job, whatever you want. I cannot exactly tell you precisely settings because they're a little bit different, vary from computer to project to many other form factors. But I'm going to try to cover as much as possible. So first thing we're going to do, we're going to do display cal. Okay, so display cal, you can download it for free. It's basically open source software and it's very powerful. It's extremely powerful being open source, and it gives you a lot of different options. First thing, for this video, I'm going to be using my iDisplay calibration tool over here, okay? I'm going to plug in this thing in a second. I have this thing plugged in. And like I said, we're going to do first thing as a color management. So your device is ready to go. In the color management options, and you're probably going to do the same thing for the Mac. I'm not too much on the Macs, but you're probably going to have the same thing. One thing to keep in mind, make sure your monitor have RGB mode, meaning you can manually control RGB within your monitor. Now, your monitor gamma doesn't really matter, technically. Most monitors are going to be 2.2 gamma, and it's okay. You don't need to have 2.4 gamma monitor to properly calibrate it for Rec. 709. You know, I know some pros going to be like, oh, bullshit. No, trust me. I'm going to show you the numbers you can do and the results accurate. I compared it personally with the BenQs, with the Flanders. It's identical. Again, that's just in my experience. So anyways, here we have my display. This is my old screen. Let's say this is my main display. Now, output levels, make sure you have full range over here from 0 to 255. Now, your instrument is going to be your calibration device. Like in my case, it's iDisplay Pro. Spiders, they're okay. They're not as good and they're very slow. So if you're planning on becoming like a colorist, like full time, get iDisplay, because with spiders, you're probably going to have tough times and calibration takes forever. Plus, they're not exactly that accurate. They're still doing a good job, but they're not exactly that accurate. So mode, leave it default, LCD, okay? So this basically is the first tab. Now the second tab, this is where everything happens. Again, I'm gonna give kind of a general idea to you guys, because I can't really, you know, take into account everybody's different systems, but I'm gonna show you how to do basically accurate, in this case, Rec. 709. So for the observer, leave whatever you have default. So in this 1931. White point, also don't touch it. Now, white level. So white level is basically your nits. It's the brightness, okay? Now, the calibration, in most professional calibration houses, their brightness set between 80 nits, 220 nits for standard Rec. 709. I like to be a little bit brighter. That's why I'm doing 120. So anywhere between 80 to 120, you're fine. I do also a little bit photography, so to me 120 works perfectly. I know my screen, I have a lot of experience, you know, working with different formats and all that. I can probably at this point even do color grading on uncalibrated display. But 120 works for me. Now the black point, self-explaining, generally darker better. I have over here 0000001, okay, bunch of zeros, so that's pretty much pitch black. Now, tone curve. In my experience, if you don't have proper Rec. 709 monitor, you can set to Rec. 1886 and Gamma 2.4. Even if your display cannot give you 2.4, most likely your display 2.2, you still can get accurate results as long as your display generally covers sRGB. So with this kind of settings, we're going to basically do Rec. 709. Now, ambient light level adjustments. I do not recommend touching this because you should leave your screen always with, you know, with the same ambient. You don't want to have any kind of variables going on. So leave it on. Calibration speed, very high, preferably. Probably you can lower it if you're not sure if it's gonna do a good job. So in my case, very high is working good for us. Okay, now next step, profiling. Profiling, very simple. It's basically, it's a test chart. In your case, select auto optimized and increase the number to something about 2000. In my experience, 2000 is a very solid number. You don't need to go more. I've tested different variations. I didn't see any kind of performance, you know, the better quality from doing more than that. I'd say anywhere from 1000 to 2000, you should be good. So, again, that's my experience. Your results may vary. Again, I'm just showing general results. Now, 3D LUT. As of right now, we don't need this. This 3D LUT gonna be the second part where I'm gonna show you how to create a different method of calibration. So verification. Verification after the calibration done, again, it's gonna display a number of patches to verify how accurate calibration went. Obviously larger is better, don't go too crazy, and also don't go too low. So with this kind of settings, I have 325. I believe by default it's something like 50. So this works in my case very well. Okay. So as of right now, everything's pretty set. Okay. Let's go to calibration screen again and let's click calibrate and profile. And you're gonna see a big gray square shows up on your computer monitor. Now at this point, you want to have your calibration device on your monitor. I placed my calibration tool right over here. And by the way, if you're going to use this display for color grading, for example, again, DaVinci Resolve, you know that your viewport is going to be somewhere around here. And I highly recommend placing your calibration device exactly over here. A lot of times, lower-end monitors, well, most of the times, lower-end monitors, not consistent with the color output and luma output, so you want to get the closest results, preferably where the image is going to be. So in our case, it's going to be somewhere around here, okay? So that's great. We set everything up. Now let's click Start Measurement. Okay, when we click Start Measurement, we're going to see this little funky icon showing up. And basically what that means, that it will align everything over here where we see arrows to the quality of our current state. So we know that right now we're doing 1886, 2.4 gamma, right? And the brightness 120. So it knows the program and it's going to compare what's the state of my monitor right now. And if it's wrong, it's gonna tell me where I need to correct it. So this is a fantastic starting point. That's why you need to have your monitor RGB controls, because otherwise you won't be able to dial it precisely. Okay, let's click start measurement, and we're gonna see that this thing displaying different kind of color patches, basically. Okay, and once it's done, we can see, for example, that I have a little bit brighter than it's supposed to be, and my blue channel is not saturated enough. Okay, I don't have enough blue. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go in the menu. I have camera going on over there, and I hope I hope you can see what I'm doing, but I'm sure you're gonna get the point. Okay, so we can see how actually moving this produces different results. This means that the panel is not good, or my monitor actually going out. I don't use this monitor for work anymore. I have external monitor. I have LG, but we can see how moving this thing makes a huge difference. Anyways, okay, so let's go to color, brightness. First thing I'm gonna do is increase the brightness by this, according to this new point, okay? So now we have everything green, so that's good. Now, let's see, I'm gonna go down, and like I said, even though you have gamma 2.2, believe me, you're gonna be fine. So we're gonna go to gain, and I have right now RGB. Hopefully you guys can see it from my other camera over there in the back, but again, you got the point. So with RGB, I'm gonna start increasing this a little bit, so all our results are neutral. So we can see everything is green right now. At this point, we can see that it's being consistently green. Okay, it's keep updating like every second. I can click on stop measurement. And at this point, I can click continue to calibration. And it's gonna take me through a series of 2000 patches, you know, taking a snap of every patch and doing its magic behind. So this is how you calibrate for your operating system, for color management. Okay, I'm gonna cancel this one because I don't wanna make you wait all that time. So this is method number one. Now, method number two is a professional method. So let's say that right now I have external monitor. Now you can use small HD, you can use any kind of higher end monitors, as long as they accept the LUT. As a matter of fact, you can even use your TV. If you have the LUT box, it's a little device called LUT box. You basically can load the LUT, and it's kind of goes between your computer and the monitor, and it's gonna reflect, you know, the LUT adjustments, basically. You can also do it within DaVinci Resolve, but usually when you load a lot with DaVinci Resolve, it slows down performance just a tiny bit, and it's not necessarily the most optimal method of color grading. It has multiple issues, and I personally don't like it. I really like loading it directly to the monitor. That way you get the most accurate result. Anyways, I'm going off a little bit over here. Now, the second method is a little bit more tricky. So instead of your display over here, we're going to select DaVinci Resolve, okay? Again, everything else I leave the same. Calibration, again, depending on what kind of monitor you have, you can leave, again, 1886, 2.4, same 120, giving disclaimer again, this is as example, okay? Blackness, the darkest possible. Okay, profiling, again, everything's the same. One difference is 3D LUT. First of all, we have to select create 3D LUT after profiling. And here, basically, you're gonna dial what you want your LUT requirements to be. So I'm guessing if we're doing sort of Rec 709, here's all our parameters over here, whatever you wanna choose, source color space, and the tone curve. So that's up to you. I'm not gonna go over those things. This process a little bit tricky, you know, I can just randomly say, okay, use this, use that, different project, different monitors. You kind of need to know in this particular case what exactly you're dialing. But for the sake of video, let's leave it like that. So right now everything looks cool. 3D LUT resolution. Not all monitors support 65. I believe most monitors go between 17 to like 33. So make sure also keep that in mind. You don't want to waste 1 hour calibrating later just to find out your LUT is not working. Okay, so 3D format, again, whatever your system takes. Dot cube, pretty much standard, you know, for resolve, let's say. Anyways, so now I'm gonna launch DaVinci Resolve, okay? And I'm gonna click over here, calibrate and profile, and you're gonna see what happens right now. We're gonna see a little IP address, and I'm gonna show you in a second what exactly that means. So we are in Resolve. I'm gonna just quickly drag the clip that I shot some random by the street. You can use whatever the hell you want. It doesn't matter. As long as you have new timeline, it needs timeline, kind of like After Effects. It needs something, you know, to create a comp. Basically, same thing goes here. So let's go in the color. And in the color, we're going to go to Workspace, Monitor Calibration, and we're going to select Kalman. And in the Kalman, we're going to dial the magic numbers. 192.168.05, and we're gonna click connect. So it says it connected. So what that means that we're gonna go back to this and we're gonna click start measurement. So now instead of our operating system generating, DaVinci Resolve going to generate all those patches. So I'm going to click OK. And I'm going to click Start Measurement. Okay. Just like that. In my case, again, everything over here is properly displayed. Now, obviously, make sure that you're going to be doing this on the display that you want to calibrate. So in this case, everything is okay. I'm going to click stop measurement. If parameter is a little bit off, you adjust them. And you're going to click continue to calibration. And it's going to be exactly the same thing like a previous method. But in this case, in the end, it's going to generate a 3D LUT for you. That way you can use on your monitor or whatever the hell basically you're doing. So that's about it to this calibration method. It's not that complicated. Just make sure you kind of know, you know, what you're calibrating it for. Obviously, this video is just a general kind of idea what those some of those numbers means. You know, more advanced obviously goes more complicated than that. But in general, if you kind of follow those steps, within the Rec. 709 or even sRGB, you should be golden. So hopefully that answers some of your questions. And if you have more, leave a comment below. And I'll see you guys soon. Take care.